purpose. And that's what we really focus on within our community, which is Christian entrepreneurs building your business with purpose. Because so many people build business because they want freedom. They believe freedom, business is the source of freedom. They want money. They believe business is their provider. And money is great. Having freedom in your schedule is awesome. Being able to travel at a moment's notice is great. But I know that my profit, I know that my provider, I know that my freedom comes from one place, and that's Christ.
That's
and so does my purpose. And so I want to build, and I know several other people, hundreds, thousands of people in this community want to build business, not just for profit, although that's good, but for purpose. They want to create impact in the world. They want to change people's lives. And that's why I coach. That's why I help people land high ticket clients, because so many people right now are struggling to land $100 clients, $200 clients, $500 clients, because of the money relationship, the toxic relationship they have with money, because they've been taught, maybe even in church, money is evil.
Right.
When the reality is, money only becomes evil when it becomes our provider, when we put our trust in it. But when we have trust in God, God's gonna provide what we need to do His will, and money just becomes the tool at that point. And so I help people overcome that toxic relationship they have with money so they can land higher ticket clients and be able to do work they love. My very first client paid me $10 a month for 3 months worth of coaching, and she paid in full. 30 bucks.
I hope so.
30 bucks. I was so happy. But then immediately after she hung up, I regretted giving her such a big discount. But I did it because I was so scared of hearing no. I was so scared of rejection. I was so scared of being seen as someone who's all about the money. And so I charged so low, but later regretted it. And it was at that moment that I realized I would rather hear no for a price I feel good about than hear a yes for a price I'll later regret.
That's right.
And what I realized was the more I charged, the more confidence I had and the more confidence my clients had in the transformation that I was able to provide them through coaching or consulting, or whether you're a freelancer service provider, I have a marketing agency as well. So no matter how you're serving someone, your price is gonna communicate your confidence, and we help people overcome the toxic relationship they have with money so they can charge a higher price.
Yeah, I love that. And Shawn, and I was, like I was telling him prior to the actual recording of our podcast right now, is that I was looking at one of his videos on his website, and he was talking about how he knew he had to go to this conference, and it would cost $5,000 to go, and how he did it. Can you just share a little bit, you know, briefly that story and how that catapulted you into entrepreneurship?
Yeah, you know, a lot of people think they have to build business by themselves. They have a hard time asking for help, and that was me. I thought, I got this, I'll just read the books, I'll listen to the podcast, but I'll do it all on my own. And I remember God spoke to me and He said, no, I've never called you to do life alone. You were never called to do life alone, whether that's in business, in life, in ministry,
yes.
Whatever it is.
Yes.
I believe God always starts with a minister, but He always ends with a ministry.
Yeah.
He starts with a leader, but He ends with a team.
Yeah.
And so I knew I needed to be around people who knew a whole lot more than I did about business. Because look, I had a ministry job. I was working full-time in ministry, which meant I didn't get paid very well. I was barely making minimum wage. And I knew I needed to be around the people who knew more than I did. So I went and I looked for a business conference, and I searched online. And I found one that was perfect for me. I mean, it said startup. It described exactly where I was and how it would help me. So I went to go buy a ticket. And like you said, Edna, the lowest ticket, not like the platinum, the lowest ticket was $5,000.
Yeah.
And I thought, oh man, there's no way I can do this. But I remember God spoke to me and He said, you may not have the resources, but you can be resourceful.
That's right.
And I said, oh, okay. So I went and I scoured their website, and I found like a random support@email, and I emailed them and I said, hey, I can't afford the ticket, but if you guys are accepting volunteers, I'll move tables. I'll help with registration. I'll greet, I'll shake hands. I'll do whatever you need me to do. And so they emailed me back and they said, okay, Shawn, yeah, come on down. We'll have you volunteer. So I went and I went to go get directions, and I didn't realize the conference was actually 8 hours away from where I lived. And so I was like, okay, well, I can't afford a plane ticket because, again, I didn't have the resources, but I decided I'm going to be resourceful, and God empowered me to be resourceful. So I went to go speak to my parents. At that time, I was about 18, 19. And I said, you know, please take me. Let's drive. And my stepdad at the time said, absolutely, let's do it. I want to support your dream. And so we drove 8 hours. We rented a really bad motel. I mean, I can remember the smell to this day of that room. It was just not good. So I volunteer. And like I said, I was working in full-time ministry at the time as a media director. So it was a really big church, and we would do like the cameras and the testimonial videos and announcement videos and like the PowerPoints on the screen. So I knew production. Their technical director, their production director for the conference, ended up getting sick the day before the event. And they messaged me and they said, hey, you mentioned in an email that you have some production experience. Do you think you could step into this role? And I did. And it was easy for me because I had done it forever, but they were so wowed that I was the right person with the right skill set at the right time that they called me a week later and they said, Shawn, that was incredible. You literally saved the show. Can we pay you $10,000 for our next show for a weekend's worth of work? We'll put you in a beautiful hotel. We'll fly you first class. How does that sound? Now, for me, making minimum wage, let me tell you, like, I was a yes at $10,000. But heck yeah, like, they could have paid me $1,000 and I would have been yes.
Yeah.
And so I ended up going to that event, working the event, and I ended up working that event and another event and another event. And I start working these events where I get this opportunity to not help with registration, but I'm backstage meeting people like Michael Hyatt and Gary Vee and Damon John from Shark Tank and like all these incredible influencers in the business world. And I remember thinking, wow, this is like God moved me from the back of the room to backstage. And it was simply because I was so obedient. Good. I didn't have the resources, but I knew God would empower me to be resourceful and to find a way that His grace would open the door to make it happen. And so that ended up leading me to building our marketing agency, which is a six-figure business, and working with some incredible people. All because I said, okay, God, what do you want? Where do you want me to go? I'm done trying to figure it out by myself. I don't have the resources, but I know you're going to open the door.
That's huge. And it's funny how, like, God will, if you obey what His instruction, He will literally hand it over to you, set you up beyond your wildest imagination, and without you doing the work, meaning like you just have to show up and follow His instructions. I mean, you still have to do some work. Let me take that back. But the things that happen in your life is only something that God can do, and you can't even explain it to people asking, how in the world did you land that deal? How in the world? I'm like, I have no idea. When God puts you in that position and all you say is, God did it. And it sounds so religious, but that's really the answer. I have no clue. I just obeyed and He told me to prepare and I did it, and now I'm here.